We lived through the war in Berlin, and I was born in 38. The war started 41. 45, when the war ended, I did not remember anything but war. My father wasn't in the military. He was one of the most well-known bridge builders in Europe. With destruction already having started in the war, they left him alone, and we did not have to join the party, and he actually worked in the underground. And when he knew another big air riot was going to come, we would go to sleep under in the basement, in our pre-stressed concrete basement. And he built the house, we had that in our basement, so we never had to go to the bunker. When I heard later on as an adult what all young people went, or kids went through, if you were awakened in the middle of the night, sometimes twice, and had to walk through the next bunker, and the bombing started and whatnot. I think psychologically I wasn't influenced by it at all. And I didn't know anything else.
My name is Harry Bliley. I volunteered for the Air Force, Air Corps then, when I was going to become 18 years old. We had a little bit of training, but then we were ready to go. We went overseas and arrived to the 351st Bomb Group of B-17s in England. The very first mission we had was to Berlin. I felt it had, for years, it had this horrible feeling of, that I went on this mission that killed lots of people.
I was a newcomer, and I don't know where was it, downstairs somewhere, right? And you started talking and to me, which was nice. Somebody approached me and welcomed me. And then, in that conversation,
we realized that I'd been there.
That he had been bombing Berlin. It was very, and I mean, of course, number one, nobody was, the people who had to do the bombing weren't at fault, in the sense that they did it with great joy and whatnot. And also, I had never met anybody who had actually bombed Berlin at the time. We were still right there. Yeah.
It was really a surprise to me that here was a chance to tell somebody that I was glad they were all right.
Well, it was wonderful because I knew it had been a problem for him all his days. But Harry didn't want to talk about it. We very seldom talked about his war years. All he would say was he bombed railroad yards, but That was the extent. He wanted me to know he had never bombed where people were. That seemed to haunt him. But it was a wonderful experience for him of letting go, finally meeting someone that was all right and that could accept the fact that he had been the one that had caused her problems then, and she was so forgiving now. It seemed like it was just a release to have her say, "Hey, it's okay, Harry."
Life is full of surprises. Here we are.